Jupiter is the king of the solar system, and the king has a crown, but like, what's it made of? Jupiter has auroras. We've known this for a while. Hubble actually spotted them. But they're not regular auroras. They're the most powerful in the solar system. Earth could fit inside of this loop. Yeah, it's awesome. So before you ask, yes, Jupiter's aurora is like ours, only larger, except it's completely not like ours at all. On Earth, electrons in the magnetic field in our atmosphere get excited by the sun's energy and they bump into air particles, lighting up the skies. So scientists thought that they would find something similar on Jupiter, and it turns out, nuh-uh. We don't understand what is causing Jupiter's auroras. NASA's ideas are all wrong. Isn't that fantastic? Using a detector called JEDI, I love nerds, the Juno probe orbited our jovial planet repeatedly, taking measurements of its magnetic field. We knew that Jupiter's magnetic field was the strongest of any planet in our solar system, which should make big aurora. And the aurora don't behave like Earth's at all, which could defy the laws of physics as we know them. To say the least, it's baffling. And a new study says the electrons that cause the aurora might be propelled faster by waves in the magnetic field of Jupiter itself, to energies as high as 400,000 volts. But sometimes the energies are way lower or are firing in weird random directions. The researchers who are studying Juno's data think that the electrons are like tiny electrically charged surfers accelerating on a wave of energy. But why the unstable random generation and the weird waves? Shrug. That likely comes from deep within the planet and may have something to do with Jupe's radiation belts. We just don't know enough yet. Pulsars, some exoplanets, and other star types like white dwarfs can spit lots of radiation and have magnetic fields that can wreak havoc on spacecraft. Learning how Jupiter works could help us build future spacecraft and keep them safe as we explore space. It's like learning how to build a boat that can survive lightning strikes or the toughest storms. But instead, it's for the nasty space weather that we know we're going to encounter. To paraphrase Captain Sparrow, bring me that event horizon. Going to space is expensive, so if you want to do it, you'd probably better learn to keep track of your finances. FreshBooks is an online invoicing and accounting software that can help. Their software lets you manage your finances or finances for a business. You can send clean and professional-looking invoices in about 30 seconds. With literally two clicks, you can set yourself up to receive payments online. You can even take pictures of receipts on your phone using FreshBooks' mobile apps. This makes claiming your expenses a million times easier. For a 30-day unrestricted trial, go to freshbooks.com/seeker and enter Seeker in the How You've Heard About Us section. Sweet jumpin' Jupiters! Take a second and please subscribe to the show. We actually visited the place that studies our aurora from the Arctic. It's called IceCat. Watch more here. Before plunging into Jupiter on a death glide, Juno learned about the planet's origins, looked for a solid core, mapped its magnetic fields, measured compounds in the atmosphere, and observed the auroras. R.I.P. Juno. Thanks for watching Seeker.